The brain, because it's so complex, it can break a lot. Mental illness seems to be unique to humans. We want to understand why. We're trying to understand which aspects of behavior and what parts of the brain make humans more vulnerable to mental illness. So how do we generate processes like attention? How do we form memories? How do we engage in social interactions with one another as a species? And if I could do translation of this knowledge into how do we treat disease, maybe how do we come up with new surgical interventions, maybe how do we come up with new medication or new techniques actually to treat brain disease, that would be actually a dream. The experience of graduate students and trainees in my lab, what I try to do with them is to stimulate this curiosity and this collaborative spirit. I think that all the trainees in my lab, they collaborate with each other. The training that they receive in my lab, it goes from surgical techniques to operant conditioning to molecular techniques to do anatomy. So we are not locked into one field and one technique. I think in our lab, we actually span a variety of techniques. Research is something that it doesn't belong only to the scientists, it belongs to all of us. I do believe that what makes us humans is this eternal curiosity to see how things work. When we understand how things work, we can control them. We can control things in the environment. We can control things in the heart. We can control things in the brain.